फराजी रुकिए, फराजी रुकिए,
बस बस मीटर कर दीजिए, कुछ बैकग्राउंड नहीं
है यहां पे,
ये अच्छा बैकग्राउंड है।
एक सेकंड फराजी, पहले फोटो कर,
थोड़ा इससे लगी मैडम,
ये बराबर है।
कितना लेट मैडम आज? मैम थोड़ा इससे ही ना,
बराबर है ये यार, पट्टी
में ये पीछे रहे तू। मैम इधर से स्टार्ट करो, इधर से, इधर से,
हां इधर से,
हां
नाम सेंटर मैम
इधर देखा ही नहीं
मैम,
अरे थैंक यू मैम,
सामने जो
मैम सेंटर इधर
मोबाइल पीछे गिरोगे मैडम बोल रही है, मोबाइल पे पवन भाई, पवन भाई तुम यार मोबाइल लाइव कर रहे
हो,
चलो अंदर को चलो,
चलो
चलो अंदर
चलो चलो,
ए मेरा ट्राइपॉड है, ओए
उधर निकल ले,
अच्छा ले चल तू ही लगा ले।
वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून फ्रेंड्स, आज वेरी वार्म वेलकम टू आवर चीफ गेस्ट
नहीं पहुंच रही
A very warm welcome, and please can we start the event for today? Thank you very much. Can I call upon President Anita Bansali to address the club?
Boss, बढ़िया ही, बढ़िया ही, बढ़िया पूछ रहे थे।
अरे खोपड़ी यार।
किसकी? वो तो आएगी मारी।
That we have with us the dynamic Mrs. Farah Khan as chief guest to launch this book. Mrs. Khan, thank you very much for being with us here today. We are thrilled to have you. I'm certain that with your presence today, we can reach out to a much larger audience and spread awareness about healthy living through healthy eating. In fact, today's session. I would request President Anita Pansari to introduce our author for today. Okay.
Most enthusiastic author who has arrived half an hour before and done the session.
So I would like to invite Bhattu to introduce our moderator for today, Amisha Devi.
Good evening, all of you. It is said that the favorite sound to the human ears is one's voice, and that so goes for the very charming Anisha Bey, a sparkling personality and a cheerful voice that has been unforgettable.
Filmmaker, choreographer, celebrated television personality, wife and mother, Farah Khan. 26 years ago, it wasn't easy to break into Bollywood as choreographer, but Farah Khan, with over 100 blockbuster songs, managed to become the most sought after in her profession after debuting with Jo Jeeta Vahi Sikandar in 1992. She recently choreographed Tarife from Veeran the Wedding and Zinkar from Dharak. Her directorial debut, Main Hoon Na, in 2004 was a monstrous success. She raised the bar by turning on films like Om Shanti Om, Teesmar Khan and Happy New Year, and went on to become the most commercially successful female filmmaker of all time. A huge feat. She managed this while continuing to be a super mom to her triplets and judging reality shows with her signature sense of humor. I present to you Ms. Farah Khan. Can I request President Anita Pansari to give a token of appreciation to Ms. Farah Khan? Welcoming our author, Sharmila Rivero. And our moderator for today, Ms. Amisha Bey. Welcome to the club. Thank you so much. And now I hand over the mic, Ms. Amisha Bey, to start with the event. Thank you so much.
I'm so happy to be here in Mumbai because it's the city of my birth. Mumbai is the city of my birth, my schooling, my college, and it's home. So it's really lovely to be here. I'm going to ask Farah, of course, to launch the book. Farah, thank you so much for encouraging me to write the book. For still giving me comments all
still
the way when I was
still
writing.
Side mein side se lo
for writing
are still
flash ada
flash piche karna bhai
thank you Farah for writing the forward and for being here today. There's no greater gift to our 45 year old friendship than what Farah.
वीडियो के लिए मैम
मैम वीडियो के लिए
बस थैंक यू
सो मच फॉर हैविंग मी हियर आई अर्ज यू ऑल टू बाय द बुक इट्स रियली गुड आई हैव गॉट इट फॉर फ्री बट नॉट
and it's really, really good. My kids and me both cook from it. It's healthy cooking, which I never got when I was younger, but I think it's good that we encourage our children to eat healthy. So thank you for writing this, Sharmila. It took a good 5 years or more to get her to do this. She has 3 big boys here. They take up all her time. So let's get on with the Q&A now before you all. I wanted to thank Anisha for being here to moderate. I want to specially mention my Anisha, thank you for being here. I want to mention my mom. My mom, Ada Rivero. Just, mommy, please stand up. She's beautiful and elegant at 87 years old. She's an amazing person. She starts her day with yoga. She spends it in social services with the poor at Edinburgh Church. And she's blessed, and I am to be her daughter. So thank you for being my inspiration. In fact, my friends all over, including Farah, crave her cooking, not mine. So that's, thank you. I self-published this book because I wanted a book that was not only useful, but I wanted a beautiful looking book that would inspire people to cook healthy. And so thank you, Rotary Club of Mumbai Elegant, for hosting this launch. It's really, really sweet of you. And so do accept a token of my gratitude to Anita Ansari. Together, so I'm really grateful to her. Savita Dalmia. Is a choreographer, and we danced together with our PT teacher, Miss Motiwal, at the time where we were taught to dance. The time
we were in an all-girls school, so that is why she had to be the boy and I had to be the girl. Nothing fishy otherwise.
Francis and I started in school.
With you. Mine was more with food also, but mine was the eating part of it. So every holiday or after school, I would be at a house where our mom would feed me, and those were like my best memories of school. So you know, I'm just glad that I can do this now. So it's a payment for Auntie Ada's cooking.
You know, when you grow up in a family where there's always good food, right, you just end up wanting to eat good food always. And I think that's the challenge for all of us who like to eat and we're always struggling.
How many of us like to eat? You have not put your hand up. You're not a foodie, please get out. Then actually this book is good for you.
Healthy food does not have to be not tasty. Okay, the point of my
point is that it's not tasty, but healthy.
Yeah. So again, tell us now a little bit about the anthropology. You call it everyday love, right? So explain what everyday love is.
See, the name was just so natural to me because when I just thought about what I was doing for my kids and what mothers and parents and people just do on a daily basis, which were probably not, people don't thank you for, kind of. Is cooking for our families and planning meals and, you know, and that is really everyday love. You know, you don't have to tell your kids you love you or your husband you love you, but the fact that you're feeding them. And to me, if you really start to make the conscious decisions of what you feed your kid, that is really, truly love. So I'm saying, you know, everyday love is healthy cooking now. Trying to change the meaning a bit. And because I fed my kids lots of junk food, you know, and I did it lovingly and indulgently. You don't think about what you feed my kids. My kids would like want gummy bears, I would bring gummy bears back and Oreo cookies and whatever they wanted, you know, mango drinks which are full of sugar. And when I started to write this book and think about healthy eating and how I wanted my family to eat better, I realized how bad the junk food was. So to me, everyday love is just putting that extra effort of thinking about what you put into your food, into your plates and your family. So.
Everyday love for me is eating good food. No, of course, I think now, especially for all of us and millennial moms, what we feed our kids, everything is become quite, people have become quite obsessive about it. You know, like, are we feeding our kids healthy? I think as mothers only, we become obsessed with our kids. What are they doing? What are they eating? What are the classes they go to? What are the play dates? So I think it's good to know that because I think I'm much older than all of y'all. So our parents were not so much into, we didn't know what was healthy food and unhealthy food. So we were just eating everything, which is why at least I grew up with wanting to diet, yo-yo diet, putting on weight and losing weight and trying to, you know. So it's better to give them the habit from childhood or as they're growing up to eat healthy, and that becomes a habit for life, which we all struggle with because that habit was never cultivated in us.
Through this book is how you discover the joys of avocado.
But I just want to add on, I think that what we grew up with, all of us, was home cooking. You know, and my book, the message is that, you just go back to everyday cooking. Because whatever you buy from a store or, when we eat out or stuff, and all of that is fine. Everything, you know, eating out, eating cookies and cakes and all treats is fine. But, you know, that's once in a while. As I tell you, it's sometimes food and anytime food. But the going back to home cooking, I think, is what I'm really advocating. Because then you know what you're putting into your food, right? So.
Then I know. I mean, everyone is obsessed with their children and child obesity and, you know, like what kind of children are eating or drinking.
It's not only children, actually. 2 weeks ago, I was at a women in diabetes conference in Chennai, and it was really horrifying, actually, for us as women getting to this age of the statistics. Indians apparently already predisposed to diabetes, and so we really need to be
realize.
So, as women, also, we really need to watch out what we're eating.
Have you approached her any of her recipes?
Yeah, of course. I have Farah's famous roast chicken with lots of chili, garlic, lemon, honey, and it's delicious. Yeah, it's healthy also, it's a roast chicken. I do it in my oven.
Yeah, I'm calling you tomorrow. Okay, the entire Rotary is invited to my house. But no, seriously, like I've always believed, you know, the reason, again, I've had such an affinity for food, and arguably for her as well, is that food brings, the great thing about food is the ability to bring people together. That there are these wonderful traditions, these tastes that we inherit, you know, all of that. So can you take us to sort of again back to where it began for both of you?
I discovered like Goan food and Goan because I was, had definitely not eaten any such food.
What did you have at home?
Our house was proper like Indian khana, but like more towards Muslim food. My dadi used to cook. So everything had lot of oil in it, very delicious. Lot of oil, lot of mutton, lot of even the dal was like that, Muslim dal was, the chapatis were, rotis were this big, yeah. Like that for some time, and then when I discovered Sharmila's home food, it was all like, you know, like prawn curries and saur patel, all things which I never heard of, but they were just absolutely delicious, you know. Like potato chops with mince in it, and can't say now, but I just had roast beef when it was allowed.
This tradition is coming together. Have you found sort of coming forward in your Sharmila that you've made new friends through food, fun of people?
Yeah, so for me, my social life revolves around my food, my lunches and my dinners. I even did an entire food show called Farah Ki Daawat because I was so, you know, I was so with like-minded people who all enjoyed food. And I think if you enjoy food and you meet another foodie, it's like an instant friendship. I think you all will know that. Like food and like shoes for you. I think that kind of connection that comes from food, and even when now if I have, I'd rather like call people over to eat food. It's a passion of mine to feed people, and I feel that at Sharmila's house, at her mother's place, even when I go to Chennai to her, everything revolves around the food, you know, which is really great.
Which is exactly how it should be.
Yeah. I mean, anywhere you go to a wedding and the food is not good, I want to pitch it out as soon as you come. Like anywhere you go, the food is one of the main things that you enjoy when you go out, either you go for a movie or for a party or for a wedding or for a holiday, everything revolves around food. That's a great unifier also.
It is a great unifier. It is entirely true. It is entirely true for you, Sharmila. Do you again, friendships change? I think today is actually, I would say, a testament to food and friendship. And again, the power of food.
Yeah, so food wasn't good for so long, maybe I would have thought so. Be friends with somebody else.
I think I realized that my mother has lived so long, but when Farah's food still is, every time I'm in Bombay, she comes home for she doesn't get the chance to come to Chennai that often. So, food in Bombay is still at my mom's house, so that's the blessing.
Even for yesterday, I was
at Aunty India's, she knows all my favorites now. But yeah, food, I think cooking for friends and family, and you know, making that effort wherever it's possible is a great thing. So I just love to, I always, you know, it was different in the sense that I made sure, like my kids' birthday parties, I made everything from scratch. It was a challenge, but you know, my kids wanted to have their birthday parties at Domino's Pizza or at Pizza Hut, but I insisted that we do home cooked. And I think in hindsight, they appreciate that. That was way before I wrote my book and while I was not, you know, making more party kind of food. But so that's the whole thing about just being.
But there is also nostalgia with these flavors. There was a young intern who came to the office who would bring every day these butter laden cheese sandwiches made by mother, which it changes.
Yeah, I know, you know, the butter laden chutney sandwich, homemade chutney sandwich, and I still have them, but not
that's
for
in my book. The chutney sandwich is in my book. I still serve that at the parties.
Is there something about that homemade, mother made that is more delicious than, you know,
try when there are 100 kids at your birthday party.
But one of the other things is that sort of thing is, again, also food is a family. But this is a part of the book that, you know, it's all about everyone enjoying it together, but again, minding, whether it's the thing, eating, consuming, creating. For both of you, you are creators as well as enthusiastic consumers.
Very enthusiastic consumers.
But as a family thing, does you know, all of us, we had our palates set by mothers who were kind and wonderful and just cooked beautiful food. My mother never cooked, so her mother was cooking for me. I don't know that. Yeah.
My dadi was
cooking. But I'm saying, but anyways, hence came the balance. Is it important to you also that your children are prepared to go out and appreciate the delicious things in life?
Yes, it is very important, I think. I think our kids get very set in what they eat, especially when we are at home. And I've seen it, they're very fussy or they're very stuck on one thing. Especially my son will only eat one thing and then for a whole year he will only. So it's important that when we travel with them that we make sure, that's when now they've started enjoying different types of cuisine and enjoying different types of food.
Yeah, that's so important actually, just introducing kids to variety in all of us. You know, when you eat variety, you get nutrients from a whole lot of different kinds of food. And it's not only tasty, but it also gives you a whole range of healthy food. And India is amazing because you have so much of variety from all over. And I have been exposed to actually growing up with, you know, Gujarat in Bombay, with Gujarati neighbors, Goan food, Punjabi friend, you know, Farah's food, and then lived abroad. So my book is actually a combination of, you know, sensibilities, and then now I live in Chennai for the last 20 years. So both South India, North India, and, you know, we really have a wonderful celebration of food in our country. So which we need to...
Which Anisha has travelled all over.
I think it's exceptionally beautiful.
I want to do that kind of show. As they pay me to travel and eat food every day.
I just want to say that you are all my witnesses to this. And I call up Anna tomorrow to say hi, we're going to be doing this.
No, but then you want to just come to my kitchen and cook and all that. Take me somewhere.
That will also happen. These are not mutually exclusive things.
But one thing I'd like to add, Anisha, when you talked about the family thing, I think the challenge for us new moms,
I'm a very old
mother. Moms in today's world is actually getting the family to sit together at the table. It is really.
How many of you all sit together? Wow, that's more than me. I can't get my family to sit together.
So that's the challenge, which you know.
But it's almost just 40%.
Yeah.
So 60% of us don't really come together unless it's a Sunday meal.
And that's one of the things I'm really trying to advocate, is really go back to that family meal, because that's when we sit and we talk to each other, we talk about, you know, whatever's happening, whether it's world events or what you did in your day, and you start to appreciate food, because, you know, my kids would ideally love to go and take their food and eat in front of the TV or even the computer or wherever, but I literally have to make at least one meal a day if we're all home to say, no, you know, food is at the table, because you need to focus on your food, and that becomes conscious eating, because when you're sitting and doing something else, you really don't know how much you're eating, what you're eating. So that's being eroded, that family table that we grew up with. So
I think the other thing that I haven't touched on is, you know, is everything that you also accomplish. I mean, you know, I remember when just Shanti was really sick, like there were babies coming, what happened to your babies? You had your babies came for 1 month?
No, after 3 months.
You were shooting while still pregnant.
My first and second trimester.
There you go. And you've maintained this incredible pace where you're constantly doing.
Actually, I'm not. It looks like I'm constantly doing many things, but I take long gaps between making movies, and I travel at least 3 times a year with my kids. I know babies.
That's lovely.
Yeah. Farah is really, I have to share this, she's an amazing mother. I mean, it's a joy to be with her and her children. Because she's really focused on them. I mean, she has a busy life, but when she's with her children and she makes that time, you know, she doesn't, I think, socialize as much as she can. But she really is very, very focused on her kids, and they're absolutely lovely kids with, you know.
Thank you. That's the best compliment I've ever heard. I think we all do. That's a 2 compliments. One, you're looking thinner. And one, your kids are very well behaved.
Just say, like going forward.
The first
like,
one, no one gives me, so I can go for the second one.
Back to the question, just say it now going forward. Just pay the compliments, just lead with it in life. I think it's an excellent. I wanted to ask, both parents have such a wicked sense of humor. Which has the greater influence on them?
I think, my kids have now become Kalika Bengan. So, you know, when they are with me, they are like their mummy's kids. And then the minute they see their father, they are the father's judges. So it's both, but my son is definitely more influenced by my husband, I think, because otherwise he's surrounded by girls, you know, and he's seen every chick flick there is to watch.
And you, of course, are surrounded by
boys. She has 3 boys. and they're lovely, but they eat a lot. They are constantly eating, so she's like constantly cooking, and she's making her own bread and all sorts of things. I mean, they are trapping boys. I have like very Sukhra children. But her children are constantly eating. So yeah.
That's why my book first of all took so long, because I was trying and testing different kinds of books, and it was the genesis actually was my son, who was not the youngest, was not eating any fruits and vegetables. And when I used to travel for work, and I'm like Farah, a lot of my work travel, I neglected my kids when they were younger. I took them when I could, but you know, as my route of travel involves long trips, so I gave up work travel when I realized my family needed help. And that's when I started to focus on healthy eating and what my kids were eating, and started to cut all the junk and processed food that I was buying them, and started to cook from scratch. And I become so passionate about it because the health of the family improves so tremendously. You know, that was the whole kind of learning for me. My kids had asthma, I had allergies, and all of it kind of gradually went away just from cooking home cooked food. So.
Okay, so guys, listen, I've been with PD, so I think which is the most truth form and true, I like to lead to the theme of this afternoon. But are there any questions? Does anyone want to ask any questions? Yes?
No, we don't have it. But honey is good for, you know, actually as a cough syrup, even if you have a cough, honey has probably similar effect of cough syrup.
Is there like a special honey for or anyone else who has some food related? No recipes are, recipe requests are not encouraged at this moment. That's in the book.
Yeah, that's in the book.
Questions to Farah about anything?
It was a very well-behaved
woman.
Chennai, they were asking me all sorts of things. Salman Khan's phone number.
When do we come to your house for dinner or lunch?
Okay, I'm fixing. Depends on how many books are sold today.
Boring actually,
no. Because everybody likes to eat the same thing when they come to my house, which is a yakhni pulao, yakhni pulao, but I make it differently because I make mine very little spicy. I'm not so bland. So that, then there's a roast chicken, then there are very irritating people who come to my house like vegetarians. Coupons. And then give it to them and said, please go eat and come back. So, for some for vegetarians, and we make like a Punjabi curry. You know, my food does that well. And there's a khatta aloo, which is very nice, which is like a lal mirchi wala aloo. And that's it, that they get these two things. And then we have other things, like we have a lot of fish, like fried fish, bombil. You all know Bombay, right? Bombay duck and pomfret, and then prawn curry, which we have learned from auntie. And yeah, with curry in it, but we put curry and all in it and make it like khatta, right? Yeah. Don't do it, yeah.
What about you? You said you liberty not having dinner menu, but were you supposed to have maybe someone like you for a dinner? Like, what would be on that
day? When Farah came for dinner, it was her favorites, yeah, this prawn curry and some Goan food, but also homemade breads, and I do a lot of dips and spreads, so like hummus and guacamole and desserts.
She bakes very well. Yeah.
So, and my journey actually, because I grew up in a Goan household which was largely meat eating, and with my kids I've actually gone the other way, where my book is literally 90% vegetarian, and we've actually gone, because honestly, that's, if you're looking at daily healthy eating,
I think vegetarian, largely vegetarian is the way to go. So we eat mostly vegetarian.
It's a little too on this.
Yes, like I said, depends on how
फ्रेंड है शर्मिला रिबेरो और उसने ये बहुत अच्छी कुक बुक लिखी है विच इज़ फॉर हेल्दी ईटिंग एंड हेल्दी कुकिंग। ये आपकी पूरी फैमिली स्पेशली बच्चों को जो आइडिया हम डाल सकते हैं कि अभी से हेल्दी उनको कैसे खिलाएं हम हेल्दी ईटिंग एवरीडे लव जो रोज़ का प्यार है वो खाने में डालें और अपने बच्चों को अपनी पूरी फैमिली को हेल्दी कुकिंग की तरफ लेकर जाएं।
शर्मिला जी आप क्या कहना
चाहेंगे? हाँ, माय मैसेज इज़ बेसिकली ईट Cook for your kids with love. You know, make sure your kids understand about healthy eating from a young age. Say no to junk and processed food. And teach your boys to cook. Not only your girls, but teach the boys to cook. So from a young age, they know out and they can be better husbands when they grow up. So...
Okay, but aap se mera sawal hai ki matlab kitna message pahunchne wala hai, kya log seekhne wale hai is book ko padhne ke baad?
Ye abhi book ko padhne ke baad kitna seekhne wale hai mujhe nahi pata, lekin agar aap ye book ke recipes follow karenge to definitely you will see that aapke health mein aapke bahut badlav aayega, kyunki jo har cheez jo recipe hai ek healthy alternative recipe to junk food recipe isme hai। मैं तो फॉलो कर रही हूँ, ये 5 साल से मेरे को रेसिपीज भेज रही है और मैं ट्राई करती हूँ, घर पर बनाती हूँ, बच्चों को भी खिलाती हूँ। मेरी डॉटर भी अभी इसमें से खुद कुकिंग करती है, तो ये सारी रेसिपीज शर्मिला ने मुझ पर ट्राई एंड टेस्टेड किया है। आई एम रेकमेंडिंग दिस बुक टू एवरीबडी, नॉट ओनली बॉलीवुड। ओके,
you have to base, actually the junk food is really unhealthy. It's basically salt, sugar, maida, oil, you know, those are the definitions of junk food, food that's high and all of that. So first ideally you should cook yourself. But if you can't cook for me,
that's difficult for working women to
everyday
cook.
It's difficult to
do
that. So you just be conscious of what you're eating, you know. So if you're buying a ready-made food, you read the labels. You see how much sugar, fat, and sodium, and you know preservatives there are in the food. So that's one step. Just being conscious of what you're eating, and you know, increase the amount of fruits and vegetables you can eat, which you can eat also raw, you know, fruits and vegetables and things you can eat raw, you don't have to cook.
I think so, once in a way everybody eats junk food, hum bhi khate hain, or once in a way it's all right also, but every day khayenge to obviously serious health issues honge, to जितना आप हेल्थ और अभी हेल्दी ऑप्शन सब जगह मिलते हैं, अगर आप खुद भी नहीं पका सकते हैं तो हेल्दी ऑप्शन आपको हर जगह मिलते हैं।
ओके, पर कोई ऐसी टिप देना चाहे जो लोग लें और जो डेली मतलब रोजाना लाइफ में वो ले सकें, जो सिंपल हो, इजी हो, जो आपकी तरफ से हो?
या मेरी तरफ से सिंपल यही है, मैं कब से बोल रही हूँ कि बहुत सारी चीज़ें आप चेंज कर सकते हैं, कि आप जैसे मैंने एरेटेड वाटर बंद कर दिया है पूरा, मैं बहुत पहले बहुत सारे एरेटेड कोलाज एंड सोडाज हर मील के साथ, you have just cut it off, no, have a nimbu pani instead without sugar, or just
coconut water,
it's easy to do that, jo aapko bhi nahi lage ki main nahi pi rahi hu, and actually jo zero aur diet cola se wo to aur bhi kharab hai kyunki usme aspartame hota hai, so I think that is even more dangerous. So that definitely, that I've cut out. You can cut out refined sugar. छोटा छोटा चीज़ change करो, because आप पूरा करने जाओगे तो मुझसे भी नहीं होता है. तो जैसे अब मैं गेहूँ का आटा नहीं खाती हूँ, मैं बाजरे की रोटी या ज्वार की रोटी उसका आटे का बनाकर चपाती खाती हूँ, तो सिंपल लाइक दैट. थोड़ा अभी घी, जैसे मैंने कहा घी बैक इन फैशन है, घी इज कम ऑर्गेनिक, घी इज कंसिडर्ड टू बी हेल्दी,
इट्स अ गुड फैट.
सो try to put little ghee in your food rather than some strange oil which is.
Can you throw some light on keto diet and vegan diet, and are they part of the recipes?
I don't think so, no.
See, we are not recommending any diet.
I mean,
this is healthy food.
हम कोई diet weight loss के लिए ये book नहीं है, ये अपनी health के लिए book है कि तो मैं कभी भी कोई crash diet ऐसी keto के carbs ही बंद कर दो तो मेरा भेजा ही नहीं चलेगा, क्योंकि carbohydrate is brain food is required. You know, for everything is required in the correct portion.
And what about organic foods?
Actually, organic is very good to go if you can afford it.
I agree
that organic food काफी महंगे होते
हैं. You mentioned your title, your book, Everyday Love. So can you elaborate on that? Why you have the name?
Yeah, because I really believe that the kind of cooking we do as mothers and parents every day for our kids is an act of love. And if we make it healthy and we are conscious about what we are feeding our children and our families, it is really truly everyday.
आपकी मम्मी भी पहले टिफिन बांधती होगी आपका. हाँ, अभी कौन, अभी भी मम्मी बांधती है ना.
If you cook for your families real good healthy food rather than buying them some junk food, that is love.
और ये आप लोग भी सीख सकते हैं इससे, मर्द जो हैं, जो अकेले रहते हैं कभी, आजकल तो सारे आई थिंक मोस्ट मेन कुक बिकॉज दे आर लिविंग अलोन.
This is a book that is good, very easy to cook from. It's attractive. Kids are cooking from it.
और ये मेन चीज़ है, ये सारे इंग्रेडिएंट्स इंडिया में बहुत इंडियन इंग्रेडिएंट्स हैं. ऐसे कभी कभी मैं कुक बुक लेती हूँ, फमेलो सैलेड और ये कहाँ से ढूंढूँ समझ में नहीं आता, तो ये सारे इंग्रेडिएंट्स आपको आपके लोकल मार्केट में मिल जाएंगे.
और इसमें पूरा एक सेक्शन है ऑन होममेड फास्ट फूड.
हाँ, करेक्ट करेक्ट, मैं ही करती हूँ कुक. मैंने एक पूरा शो बनाया था यार कुकिंग पे. हाँ, अगर मेरे को फूड बेस्ड फिल्म्स देखना बहुत पसंद है, ओके, जिसमें दिखाते हैं खाना, और इट्स आई लव दोज मूवीज वेयर यू शो गुड फूड एंड गुड कुकिंग एंड ब्यूटिफुली शॉट. तो कभी डेफिनेटली ट्राई करूँगी, लेकिन प्रॉब्लम होगी ना फिर, मैं वो फिल्म में बहुत मोटी हो जाऊँगी. वो फिल्म बनाते बनाते. ओके, थैंक यू.
क्या बात है, कंट्रोवर्शियल क्वेश्चन.
आराम से सब कुछ.
एक्चुअली वी वांट टू ऑल्सो थैंक द रोटरीज वुमेन्स क्लब ऑफ मुंबई बिकॉज़ दे हैव ऑर्गेनाइज्ड एलिगेंट रोटरी क्लब ऑफ मुंबई. रोटरी क्लब ऑफ मुंबई एलिगेंट, जिन्होंने ये बहुत अच्छा सेशन रखा आज
इंटरनेशनल सेशन. फाइंड आउट थैंक यू.
Done.
Thank you.